بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله على محمد وآله الطاهرين. Dear viewers, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Some people wonder why did Imam al-Mahdi عجل الله تعالى فرجه الشريف go into غيبة. How come? There are many reasons for this. One of the reasons to address the غيبة of the Imam سلام الله عليه is to test the people as a means of test. In Kitab al-Ghaybah, or in the book of Kamal al-Din wa Itmam al-Ni'mah by al-Shaykh al-Saduq, Ridwanullah ta'ala alayh, he lists the reasons for the ghaybah of several prophets and how that changed the people after the ghaybah of their prophet. For example, موسى عليه السلام. Prophet موسى سلام الله عليه, when he was asked by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or ordered by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to come to receive the Torah, he told his people that I'll be leaving for 30 days. Upon leaving, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told Prophet Musa that I will be extending your stay by 10 more days. So in total, you'll be 40 days. Before leaving, the Prophet Musa alayhi salam made his brother Harun as the leader and the commander after him. He left, as we read in the Holy Quran in more than one verse. What happened after Prophet Musa left, my dear viewers? Interestingly, it is said that up to 30 days, people followed Harun alayhi salam because Prophet Musa alayhi salam is gone, and he told them, I'll be back in 30 days. On the 31st day, when Musa did not return, people thought that he perished. People thought that, khalas, Musa is not coming back anymore alayhi salam. And so what happened? A man by the name of Samiri came up and he told the people that let us worship a calf. Give me your gold and I will create for you a calf, a god, wal'iyadu billah, in the form of gold. And that's indeed what happened. People gave him the jewelry, the gold, and he created for them a calf or a cow that they started worshipping, wal'iyadu billah, al-ijl, and instead of worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. By the 34th, 35th day, give or take, the synthesis, the creation, the making of this golden structure was completed, and Bani Israel, the children of Israel, started worshipping this created God, wal'iyadu billah, instead of the creator. Even though Harun told them, this is not right, you should be following Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, do not do this, but they did not obey him. And it is said that about 600,000 people approximately neglected the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, started worshipping. Only about 12,000 people remained on the path of haq with Harun alayhi salam. So the majority of the people unfortunately deviated from the haq, and that is because of the ghaybah of their prophet Musa alayhi salam. When Prophet Musa alayhi salam came back, that's when the people realized how mistaken they were. And of course, he talked to them. And the verses are mentioned in the Quran, how they regretted what they did and they repented. But had Musa alayhi salam not come back, what would have happened to the people? So the absence of Musa, the ghaybah of Musa alayhi salam, was a time of a test for the people. People are to be tested. Who will be staying steadfast on the faith and the belief in Imam al-Mahdi al-Muntadhar ajalallahu ta'ala farajahu al-Sharif, and who will deviate wal'iyadu billah. Now, it is important at this point, my dear brothers and sisters, to say that although al-Imam al-Mahdi al-Muntadhar ajalallahu ta'ala farajahu al-Sharif went into ghaybah, the preparation for the ghaybah of the Imam began from the time of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. He mentioned to his companions, and in essence to all of us, that there will be a Mahdi coming from my progeny who will have a long occultation, ghaybah, But people will not be seeing him, people will not be interacting with him. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was trying to prepare the people psychologically that he will be in ghaibah. Then later on, even Imam al-Sadiq alayhi salam came and said that there will be a ghaibah, an occultation for the 12th Imam, ajallallahu ta'ala farajahu sharif, al-Mahdi al-Muntadhar, salamullahi alayhi. And when a person asked him, what will people benefit from him being in occultation? He said, just like the sun when it rises, but there are clouds that hide it. You would still reap the benefits of the sun. You can still realize that it is day. The sun does exist. The cloud really, they're just a cover, but they do not stop the benefit from the sun. And similarly, even though he will be in ghaibah, but his benefits will still be received. And then later on, we find in the latter Imams, alayhim as-salam, first of all, Imam Al-Kadhim, salamullahi alayh, for a few years he spent in the prison, so people did not have access to the Imam, salamullahi alayh. Then with other Imams like Imam Al-Hadi, alayhi as-salam, Imam Al-Askari, salamullahi alayh, when they were summoned to come to Samarra, they were kept in a compound, which was a military compound, an area that is basically surrounded by the military. And therefore, the Shia's interaction, the people's interactions with the Imams were not as readily accessible, let's say, as they were with previous Imams, alayhim as-salam. So slowly, the Imams, alayhim as-salam, especially the latter ones, in action started to prepare the Shia for the ghaibah. And hence what they did is they started designating deputies. Imam al-Hadi alayhi salam had deputies, Imam al-Askari alayhi salam had deputies, and even Imam al-Mahdi ajalallah ta'ala farajahu sharif in his ghaibat al-sughra, the minor occultation, he also had deputies. And therefore, through this mechanism, the Imams alayhim as-salam started to prepare the people mentally, physically, and they tried to prepare him emotionally for the ghaibah of the Imam, salamullahi alayhi, his absence. And the people then were given the proper channels through which they would actually follow the Imam, salamullahi alayhi, believe in the Imam. And people are tested whether are they going to stay steadfast on their faith on the Imam, or they will, wal'iyadhu billah, reject the Imam, don't believe in him. Or will they follow some of the deviants like As-Samiri? Samiri came up and he started coming up basically with different ways to deviate the people. And there are Samiris throughout the centuries who come out and basically try to deviate the people and take them out from following the straight path. So we really need to be careful here, because one of the main reasons for the ghaibah of the Imam, salamullahi alayhi, is the test to the believers. And we pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among the successful and truthful servants of the Imam, salamullahi alayh, a true believer in Imam al-Mahdi al-Muntadhar, ajalallah ta'ala farajahu sharif, and those who will be with him, inshaAllah, in dunya and in akhirah. May Allah bless you all. Thank you. Wassalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.